Cat, if you go outdoors, you must walk in the snow. You'll come back with little white shoes on your feet, little white shoes of snow that are peals of sleet. Stay by the fire, my cat. Lie still, do not go. See how the flames are leaping and hissing low. I will bring you a saucer of milk like a marguerite, so white and so smooth, so spherical and so sweet. Stay with me, cat. Outdoors the wild winds blow. Outdoors the wild winds blow, mistress, and dark is the night. Strange voices cry in the trees, intoning strange lore, and more than cats speak, lit by our eyes' green light. On silent feet, where the meadow grasses hang hoar, mistress, there are portents abroad of magic and might, and things that are yet to be done. Open the door.
If you go outdoors, you must walk in the snow. You will come back with little white shoes on your feet, little white shoes of snow that have heels of sleet. Stay by the fire, my cat. Lie still, but do not go. See how the flames are leaping and hissing low. I will bring you a saucer of milk like a marguerite, so white and so smooth, so spherical, so sweet. Stay with me, cat. Outdoors the wild winds blow, outdoors the wild winds blow, mistress, and the dark is the night. Strange voices cry in the trees, intoning strange lore, and more than cats move, lit by our eyes' green light, on silent feet where the meadow grasses hang hoar. Mistress, there are portents abroad of magic and might, and things that are yet to be done. Open the door.
Cat, if you go outdoors, you must walk in the snow. You will come back with little white shoes on your feet, little white shoes of snow that have heels of sleet. Stay by the fire, my cat. Lie still, do not go. See how the flames are leaping and hissing low. I'll bring you a saucer of milk like a marguerite, so white and so smooth, so spherical and so sweet. Stay with me, cat. Outdoors the wild winds blow. Outdoors the wild winds blow, mistress, and dark is the night. Strange voices cry in the trees, intoning strange lore. And more than cats move, lit by our eyes' green light. On silent feet, where the meadow's grasses hang hoar. Mistress, there are portents abroad of magic and might, and things that are yet to be done. Open the door.
Cat, if you go outdoors, you must walk in the snow. You will come back with little white shoes on your feet, little white shoes of snow and heels of sleet. Stay by the fire, my cat. Lie still, do not go. See how the flames are leaping and hissing low. I will bring you a saucer of milk like a marguerite, so white and so smooth, so spherical and so sweet. Stay with me, cat. Outdoors the wild winds blow. Outdoors the wild winds blow, mistress, and dark is the night. Strange voices cry in the trees, intoning strange lore. And more than cats move, lit by our eyes, green light, on silent feet where the meadow grasses hang on. Mistress, there are portents abroad of magic and might, and things that are yet to be done. Open the door. Today is very boring, so very boring day. There is nothing much to look at, there is nothing much to say. There's a peacock on my sneakers. There's a penguin in my head. There's a dormouse on my doorstep. I am going back to bed. Today is very boring. This is boring through and through. There is absolutely nothing that I think I want to do. I see giants riding. carrying rhinos and an ogre with a sword. As a dragon blowing smokers, I am positive he would. Today is very boring. I can hardly help but yawn. There's a flying saucer landing in the middle of the room. A volcano just erupted, less than half a mile away. I think I've heard an earthquake. It's a very boring day.
We had a teacher who was so strict, you weren't allowed to breathe in her lessons. She would stand at the front going, "No breathing," and you had the whole morning to get through. The weak ones used to just keel over and die. You hear them going behind you, kaplook, kaplook, kaplook. And there'd always be a whiny kid. "Miss, can I go out and do some breathing?" And she'd say, "No, you've got all playtime to do it in." "Oh, go on, miss. Oh, go on." You know, at the start this week, 48 kids in my class. At the end of the week, there were only 5. Yeah. Well, we'd be stepping over kids just to get out of the classroom. We would stand at the front. She would say, "Right, leave." And then we would see them. "Oh, there's Melanie. Oh, she was really nice. Oh, there's Dave. Oh, but Dave always knew you're a bit weak." And people ask me, "You know, you're here now. How come you're here to tell the tale?" And I'll tell you, it's because we used to sit at desks. Not around these tables, desks with lids. And we found out what you had to do was snatch a quick breath under the lid when she wasn't looking. So once more, from the top. "No breathing." The weak ones, kaplook, kaplook, kaplook. The white ones, "Miss, keep out and do some breathing. No, you've got all playtime to do with him. Oh, go on, miss, oh, go on." Then goes our slot. She's not looking. That was a mistake. If you made any noise with the desk lid, out. School prison. There's always a school prison. Some schools don't use it as often. You'd be hung up from the walls. "Miss, I've been up here for 3 weeks, and there's rats, and they're nibbling my toenails. Miss." So what I found out is you had to put your thumbs around the edges of the desk lid so that it would make no noise at all. So once more from the top. "No breathing." Weak ones, coop, the whiny ones. "Miss, can go out and do some breathing. No, you've got all playtime to do it in. Oh, go on, miss, oh, go on." Some people, she's not looking. Out, school prison. "Miss, I've been up here for 3 weeks, and there are rats, and they're nibbling my toenails. Miss." No noise at all. Survival.
I've forgotten the name of the poet. "The love of field and coppice, of green and shaded lanes, of ordered woods and gardens, is running in your veins. Strong love of grey blue distance, brown streams and soft, dim skies, I know but cannot share it. My love is otherwise. I love a sunburned country, a land of sweeping plains, of ragged mountain ranges, of droughts and flooding rains. I love her far horizons, I love her jewel sea, her beauty and her terror, the white brown land for me. The stark white-ringed barked forests, all tragic to the moon, the sapphire-misted mountains, and hot gold rush of noon. Green tangle of the bushes, where the lithe lioness coil, and orchids deck the treetops, and ferns the warm dark soil. Core of my heart, my country, her pitiless blue sky, when sick at heart around us, we see the cattle die. But then the grey clouds gather, and we can bless again the drumming of an army, the steady soaking rain. Core of my heart, my country, land of the rainbow gold, of flood and fire and famine, she pays us back threefold. Over the thirsty paddocks, watch after many days the filmy vein of greenness that thickens as we gaze. An opal-hearted country, a willful, lavish land. All you who have not loved her, you will not understand. The earth holds many splendors. Wherever I may die, I know to what brown country my homing thoughts will fly.
You're 12, 13 at most. You're leaving the house by the back door. There's still time. You promise not to be long, not to go far. One day you'll learn all the names in the trees. You fork, left wing of the ridge. Pick up the bridle way between two streams. There's one look, there's one edge. The peak, still lit by sun, but evening overtakes you up the slopes. Dust walks its fingers in the knuckles of your spine. Turn on your heel. Back home, your child sleeps in your bed, too big for a cot. Your wife makes the bed in the light. You're sorry. You thought it was early. How did it get so late?
I'm your scalp. It was brillig, and the sly doves did gyre and gimble in the way. Or mimsy were the borogoves and the mome raths outgrabe. Beware the jabberwock, my son. The jaws that bite, the claws that catch. Beware the jug-jug bird, and shun the frumious banner-snatch. He took his vorpal sword in hand. Long time the map's own foe he sought. So rested he by the tantum tree, whom stood a while in thought. And as in uffish thought he stood, the jabberwock, with eyes of flame, came whiffling through the tulgey wood, and burbled as it came. One, two, and through, the vorpal blade went snicker-snap. He left it dead, and with its head, he went galumphing back. And hast thou slain the jabberwock? Come to my arms, my beamish boy, O fragile day, kalu-kalu, he chortled in his joy. T'was brillig, and the slithy toads did gyre and gimble in the way, or mimsy were the borogoves and the mome raths outgrabe.